What we observe over here is an example of a series circuit. Series means in repetition, one after the other. Here we observe that each unit has been connected one after the other. Therefore, it is a series circuit. In this, if I switch on one switch, what do we observe? Yes, we observe that I'm switching to one switch. We observe that the other two bulbs also glow at the same time. This tells us that the current which is flowing in one unit is same as that of the other units. Therefore, in a series circuit, the equivalent current is equal to the amount of current flowing in each unit. If this has I1 current, this has current I2 and that has current I3, we can say I equivalent is equal to I1, which will be equal to I2, which will be equal to I3. What do we observe about the intensity of the bulbs with which they are going? Yes, we see some of the bulbs are glowing more brightly, some of the bulbs are glowing dimly. Therefore, we can observe that the voltage drop across each unit, is it same or different? It is different. And the total or the equivalent voltage drop of the entire circuit is actually the sum of the voltage drop in each unit. If this is V1, this is V2, and the voltage drop in that unit is V3, then the equivalent voltage drop can be given as V1 plus V2 plus V3. If in this arrangement, if I add more resistors, what could happen?
The bulb will glow with less brightness.
Yes, the bulb will glow with less brightness. That means if a resistor is added, it increases the resistance of the overall circuit, right? Therefore, the resistance, the equivalent resistance increases because the equivalent resistance is given by the sum of the resistances in each individual circuit. And if we change the resistor in any of the individual circuit, the overall resistance of the entire circuit will increase. Therefore, the equivalent resistance can be given as R1 plus R2 plus R3, where R1, R2 and R3 are the individual resistances of first, second and third unit. What are the uses of series circuit? If we switch on one, the whole arrangement lights up. Another thing, can you use series circuit in domestic appliances or can we use series circuit in our labs? Why do you think we can't use it in our labs?
Because if we use them in labs, then if the one circuit is not working, then the other will work properly.
If one circuit will not work, if one of the lights will not work, the other lights will also go off. Like we observe over here, if this bulb is not working, the other two bulbs will also go off.